annoying pala yun. Hindi naman alam. Prevent from doing that. They don't want to be touched. You know, let's respect that. So in this vlog, I will be sharing with you guys the things that we normally do to our dogs that make them hate us. So if you wanna know more, please keep on watching. It's me, Mommy Nay. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, please do not forget to like and subscribe. This is my dog, Theo. Say hi. So there, araw na to, pag-uusapan natin guys yung mga usually natin ginagawa sa mga aso natin na unconsciously pala, hindi okay sa kanila. Mga aso natin, one-way street siya most of the time kasi parang tayo, nakakapagsalita tayo, tapos sila hindi. So, ito yung mga research ko na hopefully matulungan din kayo na to build a better relationship with your pets. So, without further ado, let's get started. Ito, number one, repeating commands. Like, more than 3 times or more than 2 times pala. That is super annoying to dogs. Kaya po kasi when we try to repeat the words all the time, you kind of devalue the command. Eh, hindi ko naiintindihan kasi dati talaga ganito ko. No, 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 no. Mas maganda pala when you say sit. Go. Boy. So mas okay pala yun na one word lang. Dapat makinig na siya. Mag-inform ka lang with how you say it. Pero if you ask me, eh, paano kung sinabi ko one time kasi hindi nakinig? Then you have to get his attention. So usually, you do this. Theo. Hindi ko pa sinasabi, pero alam niya kasi na he needs to behave. Number 2. Feeling ko lahat ginagawa to. Okay, head pats. Feeling ko lahat ginagawa to kasi ang convenient sa ating mga tao. Kasi yan agad yung ulo niya. And we usually do this. One time lang. We usually do this. Pero ang proper way pala in doing or giving praises to the dog na hindi siya maa-annoy is under his chin. This part. This one or this one. Yan, dyan pala. I don't know if it happens to all pet owners, pero dogs have that feeling na parang inaangat mo daw sila when you praise them this way. Okay, number 3. Kissing our dogs. Wait, huwag muna kami mag-react. Okay. Okay, in the dog's world daw, licking is a form of submission. So, for example, ikaw, halik ka ng halik sa aso mo. You're actually giving him the right to be dominant over you. So, gets, since you're the alpha and you're his owner, dapat na i-establish na dapat meron talagang respect na kailangan siya na muna yung mag-surrender sa'yo before you give them cuddles. Or kailangan niya munang mag-behave properly bago mo talaga mabigay yung reward na yun. Number 4, not leaving them alone. So, studies show that when we're always clingy to our dogs, the tendency is they become more anxious when we leave, kahit saglit lang. So, dapat talaga na i-establish natin yung independence din na, you know what, it's okay for you to be alone. It's okay for you to be in a crate. Or you can have your me time kahit wala ako around. Para, di ba, laging happy yung dog mo. Tapos, relax siya all the time. Number 5. Okay, hindi ko na ito nagagawa sa aking dog kasi 20 kilos na siya. Pero, feeling ko guilty yung mga mommies dito na merong mga toy dogs. Yung carrying them like a baby. Tao ba na nakaupo? So, they were built to walk on 4 legs. So, when you make them sit down like that, the pressure goes to their back. And, akala mo, ang cute. Akala mo, parang baby. Pero technically, you're kind of hurting your dog. Okay guys, so let's prevent from doing that, diba? So, number 6. I've always discussed this, but it makes them hate us when we do not provide a certain routine for them or a structure. Anytime lang convenient sa'yo, dun mo lang siya papawiwiin. O kaya parang walang certain time for feeding time. Kapag hindi ka gumagawa ng certain structure, innate for the dogs to create a structure for themselves. So, gumagawa sila ng kasarili daw nilang rules. So, ayun nga, iihi sila anytime they want. Pag gutom na sila, tapos you don't feed them on time, kakainin nila whatever they see, they play with anything. So, there's no rule, there's not gonna be respect there. Ito, nangyayari to most of the time sa mga walks. So, yung forcing them to interact to other people or to other dogs. Kaya ako nga nilalabas for the dog to socialize. Dogs can also be compared to humans, no? Hindi naman all the time ready kang mag hi, hello sa mga tao, diba? May moods din naman yung dogs, and let's give them a break. And somebody approaches them and they don't want to be touched, you know, let's respect that. I think the more we respect them, the more they're gonna respect us back. Okay, another thing that makes them hit us is tight leashes. So, ayun, lagi ko itong in-explain na it is possible for you to walk with your dog very calmly if you really train them. So, marami akong natutunan sa aking dog training class nung pinasok ko si Theo. Okay, so I'll link it below. So, ayun, it makes them, pag may tension sa kanilang neck, nagkakaroon din talaga daw ng tension sa kanilang bodies. And it makes them hate us. Hindi naman makes them hate us. Yun nga, uncomfortable talaga for them, guys. So there you have it, guys. Hopefully, may natutunan naman kayo sa vlog na ito. If you have any comments or meron pa ba kayong mga ginagawa sa mga pets nyo na feeling nyo na-annoy sila or dapat talaga i-prevent, educate me as well. So, ayun. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you again on my next vlog. Bye! See you, see you, bye!